ArcGIS apps support workflows. The design is not just to have a cool app, but to connect the app into a workflow environment. And I shared some of those with you in the field. Also, office apps and community apps are enabling entire organizations to get connected in different spaces and beyond organizations. Esri produces a series of industry-focused apps and capabilities. These are largely organized around industries like local and state government or utilities or emergency management. And these are apps and solutions which are open source. You can just download them, and they simplify and accelerate making your systems come alive. There's been like 500,000 of these downloads and millions of deployments of them. For users who wish to create their own apps, we have two environments or two frameworks. The Web App Builder, which allows in HTML5 or using JavaScript to take widgets and build very powerful 2D and 3D apps in minutes or hours, no programming required. And similarly, in device apps, there's a technology known as App Studio, which allows you to build once, like you build it once for iOS in the cloud, and then you can deploy it in Android or in Windows or in Linux or in the Mac. This is accelerating how people build apps. And we're making lots of progress here. You'll see it during the workshops. Speaking about the third component, ArcGIS Desktop, we think of it as the professional's GIS. And our focus here is on ArcMap and providing continuing ongoing support, by the way, just to clear it up, long into the future. But we're putting our focus in terms of new innovation on ArcGIS Pro. And here, a large team is making improvements that you've asked us to prioritize, like annotation editing, charts and graphs, 3D editing with things like stereo, ortho mapping, massive point cloud, and on and on. You'll see some more of that in a few minutes. What's coming next this fall is the support for that new data model of utility networks and better support for metadata and parcels. ArcGIS Desktop has a series of extensions. Some of these are for administrative things and data compilation. But my two favorite are in the science space, frankly. Spatial analysis, spatial analyst, enrich some of the modeling capabilities that users do, and network analyst as well. The third leg on this stool is ArcGIS Enterprise. Last winter, we released a new next-generation server platform, 10.5. And it included Portal, that experience that organizes all aspects of a GIS, and the GIS server, what users have been used to in the past. But this architecture is new and different. And I want to make this point. You may not experience it initially that way because it's seamlessly a rollover, but this architecture is modular and massively scalable. It means not only are my two anchors, Portal and Server, scalable, like to dozens of computers or dozens of cores, but also integrated in with it are specialized servers like the image server or the geoanalytics server, the big one, or the real-time server. So this architecture I want you to pay attention to this week, because it's not only a whole new generation of tools, it'll also allow us to scale out and take GIS inside the organization or among organizations to scale. Now, what have we done in this specifically? First, we've made a lot of new improvements like simplifying administration, or implementing the Python API, which opens access to services, and the portal-to-portal replication, and other things. In the lower right, you'll notice one big thing for me. server has always been difficult to set up. I need to have an IT guy. Sorry about that. That's not in the notes, by the way. We have simplified install, and you'll see it in a few minutes, with a new technology called Enterprise Builder. I can just set it up and it works. And for complicated environments, we've integrated Enterprise with Chef, so I can have menus for implementation of complex configurations. At this release, this summer, we're introducing a new extension called the ArcGIS Monitor, which allows you to monitor the health and performance of your system as a standard component. Coming next year will be not simply the release of the utility network, but also these improvements of metadata and parcels. Active in our development area are figuring out how to integrate machine learning environments and do predictive analytics at scale. I'm going to drill into two of these capabilities. The first one is something that many of you have asked for. It's portal-to-portal content replication. This means being able to take the items from one portal in one department and share it with another department and its related content. Quickly, you can think of the idea of having multiple departments and having a portal of portals for the whole city or the whole agency or for multiple organizations, and then replicating in the outside, the external, for external communities like the GIS hub notion, I can replicate my items, web maps, scenes, layers, and their related content to external communities automatically. So I don't have to do all the administration. I set it up, some rules, and pfft, we can take distributed GIS and integrated GIS to scale. I thought that would get a lot of applause, but apparently I'm the only geek that likes it. I'd also like to mention this API for Python, and we're going to do some demonstrations of this after the break, but this is something that enables scripting and automation of Enterprise at the command line level, or building scripts, or the use of Jupyter Notebooks, a tool for scientists in the past, but now I think will become commonplace in your world. This allows us to automate routine work, automate analytics, build models, and do just the basics of system administration. The fourth component for this morning is ArcGIS Online. And this is ArcGIS as SaaS. This environment is growing very rapidly. We now have over 4 million subscribers and make billions of tiles a day. Now, that equates to hundreds of millions of maps a day. That's scale. I don't know. We get excited about it anyway. You guys are not so excited about it. What you're probably really excited about is new things like integration of 2D, 3D smart maps and vector tiles and better user experience. Here we're working on better search and metadata coming in the fall, new tools for collaboration between organizations, charting, clustering, and other things that you've asked for. We're on it, we're just not quite able to do everything in real time. For me, this is an interesting technology because out of it is coming a new pattern of GIS with all these millions of people using it all the time. There's a growing global community of GIS people sharing and using each other's content. And that's, they're finding data, they're exploring data, they're analyzing data, then they're making maps, then they're sharing it, just like that. On top of or in association with this technology, Esri's been building a whole new kind of GIS product. And as I mentioned earlier, it's called ArcGIS Hub. This is a way for you to collaborate with your community, take GIS to the next step. And it's built around a concept of policy initiatives. This is what often local government has. They have an initiative, and they want to make it come alive. In this case, these initiatives are encapsulated into websites and apps and maps and reports that you can roll out in your own community. Part of the power of ArcGIS is that it's a platform for developers. And here we're talking about developers who are supporting enterprise advancements, doing innovation inside of their enterprise. But also, it's a platform for the creative maker community who wishes to take components and build solutions from scratch. Here, we've made a lot of improvements in our JavaScript runtime technology, Python for web scripting, as I talked about a moment ago, and also pro customization. And this, I think, ladies and gentlemen, is perhaps you're not a developer, but having this ecosystem of developers doing this important work is really very, very enriching to our whole systems. Eshri builds a series of what we call focused application products. And these respond to specialized needs like geodesign, like the GeoPlanner and City Engine, location intelligence, like geocoding appliance, which turns out to be, by the way, the fastest geocoding appliance in the world. I just had to brag a little bit there. It is really amazing. And community analyst and business analyst, more for the community analysis and business community. And then a series of domain-specific things like pipelines and roads and highways and bathymetry and airports, and you can read the list. These all are designed to simply engineer to extend the platform. They're not independent technologies. They leverage the content that you build and work with. The road ahead for ArcGIS is rich. We're going to continue implementing about every 6 months an incremental software release. Last year, 10.5 and 1.4. Last week, 10.5, 1, Pro 2. And you see the pattern. This is a list of the R&D, or really it's mostly D, projects that we're focused on in a variety of subjects. But again, I want to invite you during this week to meet with the developers here. There are hundreds and hundreds of them here. Their intention is to be here to try to figure out what you want them to do and work on. And we have lots of priorities, but we especially want you to know that we are in service to you in terms of what you need and want.